This is the Celtic Voyager. This ship arrived in 1997, so it was the first modern research vessel that the Institute and the nation had. It's 31 metres long, and it's about 8 metres in beam. It operates about 270 days a year, all around the Irish coast and a little bit beyond on occasion. It can take up to 8 scientists and 7 crew, and it typically does maximum 10 to 14 days at sea. So the ship is very busy. It's about to head off now on the annual nutrient survey, which is a survey around the coast, about 13 days long. So this will start in Dublin, and it'll come around the south coast on this occasion and finish up in Galway, sampling seawater, sampling sediments and nutrients in the water all along the way. The other work this ship does is underwater TV surveys. So we do these for nephrops or prawns. So we spend 30 odd days a year working on the three main prawn stocks in Ireland. So those are the ones in the Celtic Sea, the Irish Sea, west of the Aran Islands, and out in the Porcupine Bank. So for those, we basically tow a sled with a camera on it for 10 minutes at a time. And we do that all over the ground, the various ground, and we measure the amount of prawn burrows that can be seen. So then you can extrapolate out and you can get an idea of the health of the stock, and that goes into helping set the quotas. The other work that this ship does, and it's highly equipped for this, it does seabed mapping. So it's part of the Infomar program, which is the largest civilian hydrographic program in the world. So basically we're mapping using modern equipment all Irish waters. So the ship will spend about 70 days a year on that, and also the geological survey will have smaller vessels working in the shallower waters. So basically we use multi-beam echo sounders to survey the seabed and produce maps of the depth and the hardness and the type of material that's on the seabed. So it spends a long time every year doing that, and we have a team from our advanced mapping group working on board, surveyors doing that. We also make the vessel available for researchers, so a lot of the academic institutions like NUIG, UCC, UCD and others will use the ship to do their research. So they apply under a ship time fund. If their proposals are of good quality, they get awarded, you know, 5, 10, 30 days in the ship to go off and perform their science. So it spends quite a portion of the year doing that work. The other work we do is student training. So we spend about 50 days a year, usually in the winter period when the weather is too bad for the vessel to operate offshore. And we do day training that could be courses that are 2 or 3 days long for groups of up to 12 students. So they'll come on board, there'll be instructors on board, they'll get to learn how to use different equipment on board, they'll get to use the equipment themselves and do up a report at the end of the survey. So this has been going on for about 8 years now and it's very successful. The vessel has done almost 600 separate surveys over a 20-year period. It's sailed about 400,000 miles in the course of doing this work, and it's basically allowed about 5,000 science days of effort. Also in the past 20 years, science has got a lot bigger and equipment has got heavier and it needs more power and more data abilities. So just the physical size of the vessel won't allow some of the latest techniques. So you're forced to use some sort of smaller equipment. The Voyager is a key tool and it's a key piece of equipment that the Institute uses to perform a lot of our sort of statutory work and a lot of the programs that we're involved in. And it's also a key piece of equipment for the academic sector, for both for research and very important for training as well. So it's performed a very good role in the past 20 years.